Hello and welcome back to Apt4U. Let us continue our discussion of permutation and combinations part 4, right? So last day we had left with few examples. We will try to complete them today. So I hope you are enjoying the lectures. In case of any feedback, please provide your feedback because they're really very essential. So bina kuch der kiye hue hum log start karte hain. So the question is, let me just select a good ink color today. Let us take blue. Fine. So, how many different words can be formed from the letter of the word Ganeshpuri? Okay, so Ganeshpuri is the word we have. So, it's going to be interesting. Ganeshpuri. Alright. How many different words can be formed from the letters of the word Ganeshpuri? Okay. So, basically, we can see that there are total 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So 10 letters are there and all the letters are unique, right? Which means that no letter is present more than once, right? So there is no duplicate. Koi duplicate kahin bhi nahi hai. Har letter ek hi bar aaya hua hai. So total number of permutations is equal to 10 factorial is the answer, okay? So the answer to this question is 10 factorial. You can expand it, no problem. So total number of words that can be formed using all the letters of the word Ganeshpuri is 10 factorial. Now they have started giving the condition. The first condition says that how many words are there where the letter G always occupies the first place. So basically you have 10 slots, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. The first slot is always given to G now. Suppose the slot is fixed. So now you are left with 9 slots, right? 9 slots. And since G has already been placed, and then you are also left with 9 letters. So 9 letters, 9 slots. So basically 9C9, isn't it? 9 letters, 9 slots. 9C9, which is equal to 1. Matlab ek hi aisa group hai 9 slots ka jo aap de sakte ho. Matlab yahi hai. Right? There is no other possible group of 9 slots. So 9C1. But now whenever you place these letters, jab bhi ye letters ko hum log yahan rakhenge, they can again permute among themselves, isn't it? They can again permute among themselves in 9 factorial ways because there are 9 in numbers, right? 9 जन है यहाँ पर, इन लोगों को यहाँ बैठा दो, तो वो लोग फिर आपस में permute करेंगे 9 factorial time. Total the answer is 9 factorial. Okay? So see, I can directly write 9 factorial, but the reason why I am showing you 9C9 because it is a good practice, right? पहले हम लोग slot book किया 9C9. Now we will multiply it with the permutation, that is 9 factorial. So basically it will give you 9 factorial. Okay, the answer to this first question is 9 factorial. Now let us move to the second question. How many letters are there where the letter P and I respectively occupy the first and last place? So first of all there are 10 slots. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Right? The letter P is occupying the first place, means P is here fixed. Letter I is occupying the last place, so I is fixed here, right? So you had the name Ganeshpuri, so P is done and I is over, right? P and I are over because they are already placed. So you are left with more 8 words and there are also 8 slots left, right? 8 slots and you are also left with 8 words. So what is the answer? The answer is, first of all, give out of 8 slots, I have to find position for 8 words, 8 letters. Into those 8 letters will again permute among themselves, they will arrange among themselves in 8 factorial ways, which is equal to 1 into 8 factorial, which is equal to 8 factorial is the answer. Okay, so the answer to this question is basically 8 factorial. The second question, fine. So I hope the things are getting very clear because we are trying to do the same thing which we have done in the earlier slides. Are the vowels always together? So we have to now find out in how many words the vowels are always together. So first of all, let us quickly write the word Ganeshpuri. So we will write the word Ganeshpuri. Fine, this is the word. Let us write the number 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. It's time to change the ink. So basically, let me change the ink. Fine. Now they have said you how, in how many words the vowels are always together. So what are the vowels? First of all, locate the vowels. The vowels are A, E and U and I, right? So they have asked you now in how many words the vowels are always together. So for that, what we need to do is we will write all the consonants together. First of all, G, N, S, H, not together, in a sense, in one side, G, N, S, H, P, R, and the remaining vowels will be placed in one box, A, N, U, I, because I said they are together, they are always together. Now what is the permutations, right? Now what will we do? They have asked you in how many words these vowels are always together. So see, the answer to this question is quite simple. Now how many letters are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now this I will consider at once as one letter. Is total ko main ek letter samjhunga, right? Together 7. So ye hame dega 7 factorial, right? Into, now the game is not over yet. Okay, the game is not over yet. Why? Because remember, in the first or second video I had drawn an eye here. Ek aankh banaya tha maine. Iske andar dekhna hai. Iske andar bhi 4 letters hain. राइट, हम लोग तो बस कंसीडर कर रहे हैं कि ये एक साथ रहेंगे, लेकिन आपस के अंदर ये रूम के अंदर भी ये लोग परम्यूट करेंगे एक दूसरे से. राइट, अरेंजमेंट. हाउ मेनी लेटर्स आर देयर? देयर आर बेसिकली 4 लेटर्स. सो अगेन 4 फैक्टोरियल. इट इज द पॉइंट. सो दिस इज द आंसर टू द थर्ड क्वेश्चन. राइट, सो इफ दे हैव आस्क्ड यू इन हाउ मेनी वर्ड्स द वॉवल्स आर ऑलवेज टुगेदर, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल टेक द वॉवल्स, कीप देम इन वन बॉक्स, कीप द कंसोनेंट सेपरेटली. नाउ कंसीडर दिस एंटायर सेट ऑफ वॉवल्स एज वन सिंगल लेटर. ओके, I'm considering them as one. That is number 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 letters ka permutation nikaliye, 7 factorial into, ab iske andar jo letters hain wo bhi aapas mein permute karenge. Kitne baar? 4 factorial times. So 7 factorial into 4 factorial is the answer to this question. Okay, I hope this thing is also clear. Now let us quickly move to the fourth part of this question. The vowels always occupy even places. So again, I have to write the word Ganeshpuri. The concept remains the same, you have to number them, okay, for convenience. Now, you see, they have asked you the vowels will always occupy the even places. So, for that, what we need to do is basically, let's consider the even places. So, you have, let me change the ink. Okay, fine. So, these are the even places, right? 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10. No doubt. So, number of even places. Is equal to 5. Alright, great. And what are the number of vowels? So the number of vowels are A, E, U and I. So okay, so the number or the frequency of vowels is equal to 4. Great. So first of all, we will try to place the vowels. Okay, so out of these five, you need any 4 positions. Okay, so you will get out of these 5, there are 5 seats available for vowels, but you have only 4 vowels, so you need any 4. So in how many ways can 4 places be allotted to vowels? Right, so there are 5C4 ways of allotting 4 places to vowels. Once the place is allotted, okay, then you have to multiply it with the permutation of vowels. Right, now what I mean to say, let me say in Hindi, ki 5 positions hai, even position, lekin aapke paas bas 4 vowels hai. तो 5 पोजीशन में मुझे 4 वॉवल्स रखना है. तो देखो 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, ये 5 है, बट वॉवल्स हमारे पास सिर्फ 4 ही है, मतलब कि कोई 4 ही लेना है इसमें से. तो या तो 2, 6, 8, 10 होगा, या 2, 4, 8, 10 और 2, 4, 6, 8. राइट, तो ये पोजीशंस हो सकते हैं. तो ये हम कैसे निकालेंगे? 5C4 करके, बिकॉज वी हैव 5 पोजीशंस बट वी हैव ओनली 4 वॉवल्स. 5C4. नाउ वंस द वॉवल्स आर पुट इन दैट पोजीशंस, दे कैन अगेन परम्यूट अमंग देमसेल्फ. सपोज आई केप हेयर ए, आई केप हेयर ई, आई केप यू हेयर, आई केप आई हेयर, दिस आई डिडंट यूज. So A, E, U, I, right? I said you 5 places are there for vowels because they are even, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. But we will place only, we need only 4 places, right? Because we have only 4 vowels. Suppose I kept A, E, U, I here. Now in this particular positions, again, now this can permute among themselves. Suppose yahan par E aa gaya, yahan A aa gaya, I idhar aa gaya, U aa gaya. So that means they are permuting among themselves in this specific position. So 5C4 into 4 factorial, okay? So this was for the vowels part. Now you have to deal with the consonants part. So what happens there? You see, total number of letters were 10, right? Total number of letters were 10. Out of that, you had basically 4 vowels. So now you are left with 6 letters, right? Okay. So we have 6 letters and they are consonants. And what? How many positions are left? Now basically from 10, you have also occupied 4 positions. So you are left with 6 positions, right? So 6 letters, 6 positions means 6C6 into those six positions, the letters will permute among themselves. That is 6 factorial. Getting the point? So the answer to this question is 5, because 5C4 will give you 5 into 4 factorial into 6C6 will give you 1 into 6 factorial is the answer. Okay, so this, the product of this, you just find out the product. This will be the answer to this last question. Okay. So I hope this is also clear. Let us quickly move to the next part. Now we come to some new types of problems. So this is something new, because so far, as I said, whatever we have discussed, the number of letters or the frequency of each letter in the word was 1, right? Because koi bhi word, koi bhi letter us word mein repeat nahi ho raha tha. Lekin yahan agar dhyan se dekhenge, suppose the word India. Sorry. Consider the word India, right? So you have INDIA. Now they have asked you what is the number of permutations. So if you say, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and you will say 5 factorial is equal to 120, is the answer correct? So basically the answer is incorrect. What is the reason? The reason is simple. The words are not unique. You see here, the letters are not, sorry, the letters are not unique, because you see I is repeated 2 times here. Okay, so that is what I said you to pay attention. Okay, whenever in a word the letters are repeated, what we do is basically the formula changes, but not much, very simple. So to find out the permutation, number of possible permutations of this word India, first of all you count how many letters are there. So there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 letters, so 5 factorial. Divide by what are the duplicate letters. So basically I is the duplicate letters, because I is repeating 2 times, so 2 times, so 2 factorial, that's it. The answer to this question will be 5 factorial, means you can write 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 factorial, right? We can write by the property of factorial, by 2 factorial. So 2 factorial 2 factorial cancels, we get 5 for 20 3 are 60. So 60 possible words are there with this particular letter. Now let me understand you the concept of this. What is the concept behind this? Suppose I have a letter all. This is the word, suppose all. Okay, all. Now there are three letters. Now what is the number of permutations? So as we discussed right now, the formula will be total number of words is three, total number of letters is 3. So 3 factorial divide by how many letters are repeated. So L is repeated how many times? 2 times. So for letter L we write 2 factorial, because L is repeated 2 times, so 2 factorial. So this will give you 3 into 2 factorial by 2 factorial, which is equal to 3. Okay, now what are those 3 permutations? You see ALL, this is the first arrangement. You can write LAL or you can write LLA. Getting the point? This is the only 3 unique permutations. Getting the point? Now suppose ye L idhar aa gaya aur ye L idhar aa gaya, right? Getting the point? Now aisa bhi ho sakta hai ki ye jo pehla wala L hai wo second mein aa jaye aur ye second wala L jo hai wo first mein aa jaye, A ho jaye. But kya ye different hoga? Nahi, word to same hi hai. So why to consider these L's differently? Getting the point? We should not consider these two L's different, they are the same words. That is why we are dividing by the 2 factorial. Getting the point? So this is the reason why we are dividing by 2 factorial. Now why we are dividing by 2 factorial? Because here they are repeated 2 times. If they would have repeated 3 times, agar yahan par 3 L hota, to hum log yahan divide by 3 factorial karte hain. Getting the point? So that's all the concept about this, about dealing with the conditions when the word has, you know, a letter with more than one frequency, more than one. Getting the point? So this, there are many examples you can practice. Okay, yes, practice kar sakte hain. Let us take one more example. Suppose Russia. Okay, not don't take Russia. Let us take some more interesting examples. Okay, come up with independence. Great. So independence. If you pay attention to this problem, we have basically, you know, the independence. The number of letters are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12, right? Independence. Okay, fine. So basically if I ask you what is the number of permutations of this word, you will be writing 12 factorial, no doubt, divide by, because there are 12 letters, right? But we know that here are duplicate presents, right? Is a letter is present more than once. So if you look at I is present only once, so no issue. But if you look at n is present more than once. So what is the frequency of n basically? If you pay attention, the frequency of n will be, you know, 1 here, 2 here, 3 here. So divide by 3 factorial into, what about D? Now D is also present 1 time here and once here, 2 times, so 2 factorial into, what about E? E is present once here, twice here, third time here, fourth time here, great, 4 factorial. And P is present only once, and I think the rest of the words are covered. C is also present only once, fine. So this is basically how you will be calculating the number of permutations of this word independence. So how do we calculate this? Quite simple, you just have to follow the property of factorial, alright, and the things will be get salt. Great. So this is, so I'm not discussing these further examples. The concept remains the same. Okay. Let us try this particular problem. In how many ways can the letter of the word algebra be arranged without changing the relative order of the vowels? So let me just take the pen. Okay. So you see, pay attention to this question. You don't have to change the relative position, relative order of the vowels and consonants. In the sense, जिस पोजीशन पे वॉवल्स है उस पोजीशन पे वॉवल्स ही रहेगा, जिस पोजीशन पे कॉन्सोनेंट्स है उस पोजीशन पे कॉन्सोनेंट्स ही रहेगा. राइट, दिस इज वॉट दे वॉन्ट टू से. मीन्स इफ विच एवर पोजिशन द वॉवल्स आर प्रेजेंट इनिशियली, द वॉवल्स विल रिटेन देयर पोजिशंस. ओके, एंड द कॉन्सोनेंट्स विल ऑल्सो रिटेन देयर पोजिशंस. मीन्स यू कैन से दैट सपोज एलजेब्रा देर आर सेवन लेटर्स. ओके, एंड वट आर द पोजिशंस फॉर वॉवल्स? सो 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. मीन्स 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. यू सी स्लॉट नंबर 1, स्लॉट नंबर 4, स्लॉट नंबर 7. सो दीज 3 स्लॉट्स आर फॉर वॉवल्स. मीन्स सो आई एम जस्ट कीपिंग वी, आई एम राइटिंग वी हेयर. ओके, द स्लॉट फॉर वॉवल, this is a slot for vowel, and this is also a slot for vowel. Means here no one else, no other letter will come apart except the vowels. Okay, so you are only allowed to put vowels here, and the remaining positions are for consonants. So basically, see, you will put only consonants here, you will put only consonants here, this place only consonants allowed, this place only consonants allowed. This is what they mean by saying that the relative order of the vowels and consonants will not change. Okay, without changing the relative order of the vowels and consonants. Means jahan consonants hai wahan consonants hai, jahan vowels hai vowels. You see, do vowel ke beech mein do consonant hai, right? Do vowel ke beech mein do consonant hai. So this is the order you have to maintain. Now how do we deal with this problem? So basically, you see, in this particular example we have the word algebra. Okay, now if you have the word algebra, so how many ways can the letter of the word algebra be arranged without changing the relative order of the word or order of the vowels and consonants? So first of all, we will focus on placing the vowels. Okay, so first of all, focus on vowels. So how many vowels are there? Basically 1 2 1 3, right? So you have three vowels, and how many places are present for vowels? So basically 1 2 and 3 places are present for vowels, 3 slots. So how many combinations possible? 3 c 3, right? So you can place these and this in these 3 positions, the vowels, 1, right? 3 c 3 gives 1, because this is only one possible pair, yellow or ye position. यही लोग एक पॉसिबल आपका कॉम्बिनेशन है, एक ही कॉम्बिनेशन है जहां पर आप तीनों लेटर्स को रख सकते हो. इनटू, नाउ आई होप यू हैव रिमेम्बर्ड, वी हैव टू डू द परम्यूटेशन, बट नाउ यू हैव टू डू द परम्यूटेशन ऑफ ए ई एंड ए, दीज 3 वॉवल्स. ओके, ए ई एंड ए. सो व्हाट विल बी द परम्यूटेशन ऑफ दीज 3? बिकॉज ऑब्वियसली ये पोजिशन पे ए ई एंड ए, या फिर ई इधर आ सकता है, ए इधर आ सकता है, राइट? ओके, द परम्यूटेशन ऑफ दीज 3 वॉवल्स. So the permutation of these 3 vowels means is equal to 3 factorial, because there are 1, 2 and 3 letters, divided by, since A is repeated twice, once here, second here, 2 factorial. Getting the point? So 1 into 3 factorial by 2 factorial, which is nothing but 3. Okay? So there are 3 ways of in which the vowels will be arranged. So now the problem is not over yet. Ab hum log focus karenge consonants pe. Focus on consonants. So now these positions are already booked by the vowels, okay, in 3 ways. Focus on the remaining positions. So remaining you have 1 2 3 and 4 slots, 4 slots. And how many consonants do you have? Again, you have again 1 2 3 and 4 consonants, right? 4 consonants. So again, the number of the possible ways are 4 c 4 into these 4 letters L, G, B and R. Okay, the permutation of L, G, B and R, you see, all are unique. Directly we can write 4 factorial, which is equal to 1 into 4 factorial is 24. Okay, which is equal to 24. So you got 24 here, in which 24 ways in which the consonants will be arranged, and 3 ways in which the vowels will be arranged. So total ways is equal to 3 into 24, okay, is equal to 72. Okay, so I hope you got the concept how we are dealing with the things. So we are coming up with more and more technically complex questions. I hope you are enjoying the process of learning. Keep learning, and as always, thank you all, and please like and subscribe and put your valuable comments in the comment section. Thank you.